Before we start with the compiler design, we must know what is language. So any system of formalized symbol, sign, etc. used or conceived as a mean of communication is known as language. So what is communicate? To transmit or exchange thought or knowledge is known as communication. So what is programming language? So communication between a person and a machine. So we need programming language to communicate with machine. Programming language is just a intermediary using which a programmer or we can give instruction to a machine. Now here is a language hierarchy. You can see here at the bottom of the hierarchy there is machine level language, then assembly language comes, then high level language comes, then program oriented language comes, next natural language, these are come. Now you can see here the level is increasing with y axis and the friendliness to the user is increasing towards the x axis. Now as you know, for any language, it is a human speaking language, say English, Hindi or anything, there is a grammar for a language. So if you want to learn a language, we need to learn the grammar first. So what is grammar? The set of structural rules that governs the composition of sentence, phrases and words in any given natural language is known as grammar. So this is copied from Wikipedia. Now formal grammar, rules for forming string in a formal language is called as formal grammar. Computer language grammar, rules for forming tokens, statements and programs. Like do in C language, if you write C code, we need to write variable names. So variable names are nothing but part of token. Statement, so we write some expression or some instruction in C code, they are called as statement. And set of statement or instruction when solve a particular problem, we call it as a program. Now different layer of a grammar. Yes, there is different layers of a grammar. We will discuss it later in detail. As an example, you can say regular grammar, context-free grammar, okay, and so on. So when we have studied formal language and automata or theory of computation, there we had seen one kind of grammar, we usually called them regular grammar. So they was used to construct string. Now, when we speak about grammar of English language, you will find them these grammars are using to construct sentence. So these are called word context free grammar. So in compiler design, you will find we are using context free grammars most of the time. Translator, so this is a very generic term. Translate one language into another language is called as translator. So it is okay for high level programming languages such as Java and C, that translator is known as compiler. So what compiler does? Translate high level language code into host machine assembly code and execute the translated program at runtime. And there is another thing. So this is not generic definition of compiler, this is the function of compiler. Okay, so another is another kind of translator, that is called interpreter. So process the source program and data at the same time. Okay, so it process source program and data at same time, no equivalent assembly code is generated. Okay, so computer language grammar, rules for forming token sentence and grammar programs. Assemblers, there is another thing called assembler. So translate assembly language into machine code. Now if you look at this, how compiler work. So we write some source code in some say C or Java, anything. It goes to the compiler, it compiles, then it generates some machine code which is going to be execute. So execution, this thing is going to happen on some processor. At that time we need to provide data which we need, we want to process, and it will, that processor after execution going to generate the result. On the other hand, if you look at interpreter, we have source code here, there is interpreter which interprets. At the time of interpretation, it needs data input, and the same time it generates the result. So here you can understand the difference between compiler and interpreter also. So what is compiler? Compiler is a software which converts a source code to target code. More precisely, if you want to say, compiler is a software which checks error, which kind of error? Lexical errors, syntax error, and semantic errors in source code and convert to target code. How does compiler work? So a compiler performs tasks in same way how a human approaches to the problem. Okay. So consider a sentence, say the cat runs. So how do we understand what does it mean? But how do we arrive at a conclusion? That means how do we understand that, okay, there is a cat and that cat runs. Okay, so for understanding this thing, what are the things going on inside our brain? So the same thing happens inside a compiler. Now what happens in our brain when we listen to some sentence? We recognize or read some sentence like this. We recognize the character and generate logical entities or words. Like in previous sentence, C-A-T. So we understand that C-A-T together becomes cat. But it may be alphabetical alphabet, it may be mathematical symbol, it may be some punctuation. Next, once we recognize it, check the word for structurally correct sentence. Yes, so either the words we have read are in correct sequence or not. If yes, check the combination of word makes sense, makes some sense. So it is okay, the cat runs, okay, it makes some sense. But if I say the cat flies, no, the cat can't fly, it doesn't make any sense. Translate to your language. So say I'm a Hindi speaking person, so I have read this characters or sentence in English. So to understand it, I have to translate the three word, the cat runs, in my own language, say Hindi. Next, after doing it, I will optimize it to better understanding, and then plan the task. If it is a problem, then I have to know response to that sentence. What response I will do, that I have to need to plan. Then if I plan some tasks, then we will take that action. Okay, so this is the way how our human brain recognizes some sentence and reacts to it. Now a simple grammar is given here. Recognize the characters and generate logical entities, words. So the cat runs. Check the words, a structurally correct sentence. We may represent the English grammar as sentence which is divided into two parts. We can say noun phrase and verb phrase. Now again, the noun phrase can have two parts. Article and noun. Articles may be A and D, and noun may be anything which represents some name, and verb phrase may have verb and noun phrase. Now this noun phrase may be again anything like boy, bicycle, cat, and verb may be runs, rides, flies, anything, right? So go to the next. So sentence, the tree will look like this. Noun phrase, verb phrase. Noun phrase may have article and noun. An article may be the cat, article may be the noun, may be the cat, and verb runs. So okay, according to this, our sentence, according to this grammar, our sentence is correct. It is in proper format, so we understand it, right? Now compiler versus human brain. So the cat runs versus